no, look at that. It's a giant asteroid coming towards Earth. But if it comes towards Earth, wouldn't it be a meteorite instead of an asteroid? After all, what killed the dinosaurs was a meteorite, not an asteroid, right? Well, there are also theories that indicate that what ended the era of the dinosaurs could have been a comet. But then, how are all these objects different? What is the difference between a comet, an asteroid, and a meteorite? Get ready to find out. We must clarify that in the solar system, there are many small bodies whose differences may be challenging to recognize, and in most cases, only astronomers can notice these differences. Still, in this video, we will try to make those differences very clear. So let's go there. Asteroid. Let's start with the simplest object of all. Well, it's not as simple as you think. In astronomy, asteroids are defined as rocky or metallic bodies that orbit the Sun in the asteroid belt. This is a region between the orbits of Mars and Jupiter. These are remnants of the solar system's formation and can range in size from just a few meters to hundreds of kilometers. Once an asteroid reaches at least 1/10 of the Moon's diameter, it is no longer considered an asteroid and would pass into another category known as dwarf planets. For example, on January 1, 1801, the Italian astronomer Giuseppe Piazzi discovered Ceres, which at that time was given the category of planet, because it was the first object of that type to be discovered, and there was no other way to call it. Eventually, after discovering similar objects orbiting in the same area, astronomers created the term asteroid to define all those objects between Mars and Jupiter that orbited the Sun and were much smaller than the Moon. In this way, Ceres was downgraded to the category of asteroid. Still in 2006, with the discovery of Pluto and other objects of a similar size, a new category was created to define those objects that did not have sufficient characteristics to be classified as a planet. This new category was dwarf planets. Thus, in 2006, the International Astronomical Union classified Ceres as a dwarf planet, an object large enough to be spherical, which orbits the Sun but does not have an orbit free of other small bodies. Hundreds of thousands of asteroids have been counted today, but here's something interesting. Do you remember the definition we gave at the beginning? An asteroid is a rocky or metallic body that orbits the Sun in the asteroid belt, a region between the orbits of Mars and Jupiter. Do you realize? An asteroid is an object that orbits between the orbits of Mars and Jupiter. What happens if it orbits outside of that region? For example, what happens to an object that orbits the Sun beyond Saturn or Neptune? Is it still an asteroid? The answer is no. An object outside the asteroid belt can no longer be called an asteroid. So what are these objects called? This is where things get complicated, since these objects have different definitions depending on their location. Let's start with the simplest ones. Among asteroids, there are different groups, NEOs. The first and most dangerous are those classified as NEOs by its acronym, which means near-Earth objects. These objects break the scheme since they are objects that orbit outside the range initially established by astronomers, that is, beyond the orbit between Mars and Jupiter. An NEO is an astronomical object characterized by a trajectory that brings it closer than 1.3 astronomical units from the Sun and less than 0.3 astronomical units from the Earth. An example of this type of asteroid is the famous asteroid Apophis, of which we already made a video, and it is an asteroid that will pass dangerously close to the Earth in 2029. If you want to know more about this asteroid, we'll leave the video in the description. In turn, NEOs are divided into three main groups whose difference is mainly the area through which they pass. These are Aten. These are asteroids whose orbit is closer to the Sun than to the Earth. Apollo. Unlike the Atens, these type of asteroids have one orbit that is mainly further than that of the Earth. Amor. Finally, these types of asteroids have an orbit that completely contains that of the Earth. Trojan asteroids. Did you know that there are asteroids that share their orbit with other planets without colliding? Yeah, they exist and are Trojan asteroids. These type of asteroids are found in precisely the same orbit as another planet. But why do they not collide with the planet in which they share an orbit? This is due to something called Lagrange points. The Lagrange points are five particular positions in space where the gravitational forces of two celestial bodies, such as the Earth and the Moon, or the Earth and the Sun, balance each other. At these points, a small object can maintain a relatively stable position concerning the two bodies, creating a rest point in the system. All planets have five Lagrange points concerning the Sun and are denoted as L1, L2, L3, L4, and L5. Of these five points, there are two that are particularly important for the topic of asteroids. These are points L4 and L5. As you can see, points L4 and L5 are in the same planet's orbit. Because these two regions are zones of gravitational balance, all bodies in those regions will stay there indefinitely. If a planet is big, the Lagrange points will also be massive. They will cover a larger area. Because of this, there will be more opportunities for small objects, like asteroids, to get trapped in these areas and stay there indefinitely. This is just what happens to Jupiter. The most giant planet of all has a strong gravitational attraction. Therefore, its Lagrange points cover ample space. Throughout the solar system's history, many asteroids were trapped in the Lagrange points L4 and L5 of Jupiter. These asteroids share the orbit around the Sun with the gas giant. That is, Jupiter and the asteroids orbit the Sun in the same orbit without colliding. But if this type of asteroid that shares orbits with other planets is known as Trojan asteroids, what is an asteroid beyond Jupiter called? In these cases, the most appropriate definition for bodies beyond Jupiter is centaurs, a type of asteroid that orbits the Sun in an orbit that may be between Jupiter and Neptune. What if there is an asteroid beyond Neptune? This is where things get even more complicated, since in general all objects that are further away from Neptune are usually called trans-Neptunian objects. However, some people often use the term Kuiper belt objects to refer to the same type of objects. Still, the trans-Neptunian objects encompasses all bodies beyond Neptune, including objects in the Oort cloud and the Kuiper belt objects. To understand the Kuiper belt, you should know that beyond the orbit of Neptune, there is an asteroid belt similar to the one between Mars and Jupiter. This is the Kuiper belt. The main difference between the asteroid belt and the Kuiper belt is that the objects in the Kuiper belt are not called asteroids, but Kuiper belt objects. The Kuiper belt objects are divided into two groups, the Plutinos and the Cubewanos. Plutinos are objects in the same region as Pluto, and Cubewanos are further away. Beyond the Kuiper belt, we find the Oort cloud, the last region of the solar system, complete of hundreds of millions of icy bodies, and where long-period comets come from. The problem with objects beyond Neptune is that they can have one or more classifications. For example, Makemake is a trans-Neptunian object, since it is located beyond Neptune, but it is known to orbit within the Kuiper belt, so it is a Kuiper belt object. In addition to that, it has so much mass that it has reached a spherical shape, which is why it is also classified as a dwarf planet. And if that were not enough, Makemake is an object in a region similar to Pluto's, so it also falls into the Plutoid category, which means that Makemake has four different classifications, all equally valid. Complete madness, don't you think? Another famous object is Halley's Comet, which not only has the classification of a trans-Neptunian object, but also has the classification of a comet. And this is where we leave asteroids aside and start talking about comets. Before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. Comets. Comets are celestial bodies composed mainly of ice, dust, and rock. As they approach the Sun, they release a tail of gas and dust that lights up and can be visible from Earth. An example is Halley's Comet, visible from Earth every 76 years. The main difference between asteroids and comets is the material they are made of. An asteroid can usually be made of rock and metals, but a comet is made primarily of ice. Could an asteroid have a bright tail of dust and rocks like a comet? There are various circumstances under which an asteroid could acquire this peculiar characteristic. Still, if that were to happen, it could no longer be classified as an asteroid and would become a comet. Meteoroid. What is the tail of a comet made of? As we said before, the tail of a comet is made of dust and rocks. But why do these materials break off from the comet? The reason for this is the composition of the comets, as they are made mainly of ice. When they approach the sun, the heat causes them to sublimate, and the mass they lose is left behind them, like that bright tail we see. But sometimes the material that breaks off from a comet is enormous. When that happens, those pieces of material remain floating in space and are called a meteoroid. A meteoroid is a small fragment of an asteroid or comet floating in space. Meteor. A meteor is a luminous phenomenon that occurs when a meteoroid of less than 1 meter enters the Earth's atmosphere and burns up due to friction. That is to say, when a fragment of an asteroid or comet is floating in space, it is called a meteoroid. But if it enters the Earth's atmosphere, its classification becomes a meteor. Meteors are very small, usually the size of a grain of rice, so they never touch the Earth's surface, and their bright tail lasts a fraction of a second. In some countries, they are also called shooting stars. Bolide. When a meteoroid more than 1 meter in diameter enters the Earth's atmosphere, it causes an exceptionally bright and spectacular flash that can last several seconds. When this occurs, the object is not classified as a meteor, but as a bolide. The only difference between a meteor and a bolide is the size. The larger it is, the more intense its brightness will be. But both have the similarity that neither of them reaches the ground since they disintegrate in the air. An example of a famous bolide is the Bolide of Chelyabinsk, seen in Russia in 2013, which exploded in mid-air, fragmenting into several pieces that fell separately on the surface. Meteorite. Finally, we have the most famous object of all, the meteorite. A meteorite is any space object, such as comets or asteroids, that impact the Earth's surface. Does this mean that if a bolide manages to hit the surface, it would become a meteorite? The answer is yes. Basically, its category would change once it hits the ground. But if that is the case, what about the Chelyabinsk car? We said a moment ago that the Bolide of Chelyabinsk exploded in the air and several pieces fell to the ground. Shouldn't those pieces that managed to survive and reach the ground be classified as meteorites? The answer, in this case, is yes, but it depends. In reality, it isn't easy to classify these types of objects. Many scientists define that with the simple fact that an object survives its passage through the Earth's atmosphere and manages to reach its surface, it can already be classified as a meteorite. However, other scientists conclude that these separate fragments belong to a bolide that did not survive entry into the atmosphere because it exploded. If we are strict and apply the same logic as with Makemake, we could say that the fragments that survived the Chelyabinsk bolide can be classified within two categories. On the one hand, they are meteorites since they managed to reach the Earth's surface, and on the other hand, they are fragments of a bolide that did not survive its passage through the atmosphere. Both definitions are equally valid. In summary, if an asteroid, comet, meteor, meteoroid, or bolide manages to survive its passage through the atmosphere and manages to impact the Earth's surface, at that moment it will be classified as a meteorite. As you can see in this video, the classifications of all objects from space depend on their location. So to recap, if they are between Mars and Jupiter, they are asteroids. If they're very close to Earth, they are called NEOs. If they are beyond Jupiter, they will be called centaurs. If they share an orbit with a planet, they are Trojan asteroids. If they are beyond Neptune, they are trans-Neptunian objects. If they are in the Kuiper Belt, they are Kuiper Belt objects. If they come from the Oort cloud, they are Oort cloud objects. They are comets if they have a bright tail of dust and rocks. They are called meteoroids if they are fragments of any of the above. If any of these enter the Earth's atmosphere, it becomes a meteor. If the brightness is very intense, then it will be a bolide. If any of the above reaches the Earth's surface, it will be a meteorite. And finally, all the objects above can have one or more categories depending on various situations. This is the complete dictionary of objects in the solar system. Tell us which of them all seemed most interesting to you. Did you know them all? Let us know your opinion in the comments.